Wonder if those rats are recyclable. The Panthers get three early goals. They hold on to beat New Jersey tonight 4-2 and even their series at one game apiece. Mike DePasquale was at the game. He has one of the big stars.
All right, Steve, thanks. We're joined by the winning goaltender tonight, Jose Theodore. Jose, first of all, just how important was this win, considering that the Devils have never lost a series and are up 2-0?
Well, I didn't know that stat, and I think obviously when the playoffs start, you know it's going to go back and forth, but you don't want to go down in their building being down 0-2. So tonight was a big game. I thought maybe the last game, the first period, we came out flat a little bit, but you know, tonight was a really solid game, a good playoff game, and it's obviously a huge win.
Oh, you mentioned that in that first game, the first period, they had 26 shots. In this game, the first two period, 13 shots. The defense in front clamped down, and you really didn't have to make those spectacular saves like you had to in the first period of the first game to keep them in it.
Oh yeah, we played really well. We played a solid, stingy game tonight, and you know, usually in playoff, that's how you win games. I think. You know, you're still going to have to make key saves, obviously, at key time, but tonight we really did a great job. The guys really played a solid game in front of them, and, you know, obviously I didn't want to let them down because they deserve it.
You had said all week that you have been here, done that before, because you had 52 career playoff games under your pads. You knew what to expect.
The key is not to panic, and tonight was a good example. You know, they scored two quick goals in the third. We didn't panic, and we were able to get a big win.
Momentum on your side now as you head to Jersey?
Well, obviously, we there's two ways to look at it. They kind of came out strong in the third, but I think it's a big win for us, and we're just going to have to build on that, know what we have to do to win games, and, you know, looking forward to the next game.
All right, Jose, thank you. Jose and the Panthers head to Newark, New Jersey. Game 3 will be on Tuesday night. Back to you, Steve, in the studio.
Thanks, Mike. There'll also be a game 5 here next Saturday, so that's good stuff. All right, Donovan's here. Something about standing on his head. What are you talking about?
You know what, Steve? We all know playoff hockey is beyond exciting, and nothing is more tantalizing than seeing great goaltending in playoff pucks, which got my wheels turning.
You got wheels?
When action in a hockey game gets furious, sometimes your goalie can be the most important player on the ice.
Has a break! Saved by Theodore!
We need to get that kind of goaltending to have the kind of long-term success we're having.
But when your goalie makes saves like this, which is referring to standing on his head, it can be a game changer.
Sometimes it's just about the way the games unfold. You can get a couple penalties. That's when a lot of time you have to make that one or two big saves.
It's not a game plan that you draw up as a coach, or it's not something you want to do as a team on a regular basis, because you know, that's a recipe for a disaster.
When you play so many games during a hockey season, everyone has to sometimes play hero. And many nights, a team leans on their goalie to do super ordinary things.
Anytime your goalie is your best player, you're going to have a good chance to win a lot of hockey games.
The flexibility they have is something that you don't see in many people besides maybe gymnasts. So we give them a lot of credit for having 100-mile-an-hour slap shots taken at their heads.
And when you're getting outstanding play from your netminder, it's sure appreciated by your head coach.
It's a huge momentum changer. I think you go out, you can score goals, but when you keep those ones up, there's this little rally, and guys go, okay, let's stiffen up here and get going, and start playing for each other. Overall, this season, we've gotten very solid, stand-on-your-head type goaltending.
It's a two-on-one with Parise. Kolachuk for Parise, the backhander, Theodore Rostov.
And there are times when you can't think, and you just let your ability and your talent or whatever you want to call it just kind of take over, you know, because, like I said, the game is so fast, you just think out there, then you don't have time. There are definitely times after you make a save that you just kind of exhale and maybe even chuckle a little bit to yourself, say, wow, I got lucky on that one. And, you know, you have to be lucky to be good at times.
Steve, I personally have a difficult time standing on skates, much less standing on my head.
Do anything to make a save. Who used the expression first? Where does it come from?
You want to know what's funny? The term was first used by NHL president Frank Kolden in reference to the rule allowing goalies to leave their feet. He said, quote, they can stand on their heads as far as I can.
My father used to tell me when I was a kid. All right, Donovan, thank you. Series moves to New Jersey. Game 3 Tuesday night, as we told you. Also today.